Bang Family Concert Series. We're being treated to some very lovely 19th century arias brought to us by some wonderful, wonderful voices. Anne-Marie Adamich is our mezzo-soprano. Dr. Elizabeth Gerby is our soprano. And our wonderful Steinway, which is our Steinway brand, was born the same year, the first time that Steinway named piano the Steinway Grand Piano.
I would like to talk a little bit about how my love of history got sparked when I moved to the Hudson Valley, and how meaningful it is to be performing this kind of music for you here in a church and a building that has the kind of history that Smithfield Presbyterian does. I moved to the Hudson Valley about 15 years ago, and of course I look around and see, well, what's unique about this area? And the history is certainly right at the top of that list. And going into these spaces, I always wanted to hear what would the acoustics be like. So whether it's going to Statsburg and Ogden Mills, the Mills Mansion, or the Vanderbilt Mansion in Hyde Park, I always wanted to go into the music room, hear what it sounded like. I didn't ask the tour guide, could I play the piano? And they always say no, until someone eventually said yes. And unsurprisingly, the acoustics were fantastic. And that sparked an interest that has really been, for the last 7 or 8 years, my primary focus of the music in historic spaces. I specifically focusing on the Gilded Age, so we're talking end of the Civil War around 1865 to maybe the beginning of the First World War around 1914 or so, is what I'm looking at as my primary area of interest. And the concept for this program that we're going to present for you is the idea of looking at 19th century opera, which was very important, not only musically, but socially. They were the films of their time, where everyone would go, not only to see and hear the music, but to be seen by the other people going. And so these operas were so popular that composers wanted to, you know, capitalize on these big hits by creating these instrumental versions, kind of like the greatest hits from the opera, that you could then, with less money than staging an entire opera, take and share those opera melodies that were so popular throughout all sorts of communities. So what we're going to hear tonight, or what you're going to hear this afternoon rather, is you're going to hear an operatic aria, and then the fantasy that it inspired. And a fantasy was just kind of like a set of theme and variations. And as a saxophonist, I'm fortunate that a composer by the name of Louis Mayor, who had studied with Adolf Sax, yes, this very same Adolf Sax you just heard about, he studied with him and then got a job in the Paris Opera. He was their bass clarinetist and their saxophone soloist. So he would hear all the great operas that would go on tour and all the companies that would be producing these operas. And then he would say, you know, I have an idea. Let me compose something for my former mentor and teacher, Adolf Sax, for the saxophone. So many of these were composed in the 1870s, long before most of us think about the saxophone really being an instrument. But it was in this time, through the 1850s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s, the saxophone was being experimented with in all sorts of different styles, including opera and bands and everything in between.
Sound like this. Oh,
hear this sound coming from the orchestra and you think, what is that sound? Because I would imagine for most Americans at that time, 1894, probably hadn't heard saxophone in an orchestra before. It might have been, and I can just imagine how perplexing it must have been for people trying to identify what that sound is. And even today, so many of us, as soon as you say saxophone, you're thinking of maybe Bing Crosby, Glenn Miller, Benny Goodman, maybe Bruce Springsteen. You're not thinking Jules Massenet. So this is going to be, what I'm going to play is the actual saxophone part from the orchestra.